What's up, CFO gang? It's your boy J-Tuck. Cowboys haters, real Cowboys fans stand up. And you're now tuning to the Cowboys Fans Only channel. So if you're new, do me a huge favor, comment, like, subscribe, somewhere down there. And be sure to turn that notification bell to stay updated with all Dallas Cowboys CFO content. Also, go to CowboysFansOnly.com. Use the code CFOGANG to make sure you're getting 10% off all of your purchases. I just fully restocked the store. So salute to everyone who's been going in and buying shirts like crazy. We even got Cowboys fans in Japan. I'll run that back. I'll repeat. We even got Cowboys fans in Japan. That's why I made the whole Japanese shirt. It's a salute to all my Japanese subscribers over there in Japan who watch my content and still support me. I appreciate each and one of you. I cannot do this without you guys. And speaking of support, I want to say thank you to everyone who tuned in to last night's live stream with me, my guy BJ Nix, Professor O, and Bluff City Cowboys. We peeled back the layers of the Dallas Cowboys Dan Quinn 4-3 under scheme. We kind of went through it slowly, educated brick by brick, layer by layer, and slowly peeled that onion back. So that way you, the viewer and the subscriber, can kind of grasp the concept and understand what's going on. So that way when we're talking 4-3 under wide non-legal concepts and different things like that, you, the viewer, can keep up with this and understand. And that's what we do on this channel. We educate, but we also have fun. We keep things lit. Also, salute to Giannis Antetokounmpo, now an NBA champion last night, man. So the Milwaukee Bucks are now NBA champions. You know, Giannis, he did it the right way, man. So Giannis is a true champion. So salute to you, bro. But enough with all that. It's football season, right? The NBA did exactly what they needed to do, and that is carry us through the offseason into the NFL season. And so we are here. If you're like me, you're watching all the Instagrams, you're watching all the tweets, you're seeing the players get off the plane with the luggage, they're checking into Oxnard, they're camp bound, they're ready, they're locked and loaded. You see some of the media already in California. Jane Slater, my guy Jeff Kavanaugh is already there. Like, everyone is ready for Dallas Cowboys football, and I couldn't be more excited. So people's been asking me, Tuck, when are you going to be at camp? Tuck, where are you going to be at camp? I will be at camp next week. Right. So I actually land in California next Friday is when I'll be there. I actually be out in Vegas for a little bit and then I'm going to Oxnard. Right. But I'll be in Oxnard next Friday because I wanted to wait until the pads come on because I want to see some pads clanging, man. So I'll definitely be out there giving y'all content, linking up with other content creators doing shows. So definitely stay tuned into that. So I want to dive into a few things, and I know the title kind of says top five, right? But I ain't got no notes or nothing. I'm kind of shooting off the hip, you know what I'm saying? But I have a few things that I'm definitely going to be keeping my eye out on during camp and also during the Dallas Cowboys preseason. So I might give y'all 6 or 7. I might give y'all a little bonus today because I appreciate y'all rock with me and I rock with y'all, right? So the first thing is, do the players get it defensively, right? We brought in Dan Quinn. We brought in some of these new coaches to kind of fix what was broken last year. So where I'm actually watching camp, right? I'm watching preseason. I'm watching some of these players, how they interact. Are the defensive players out there getting the scheme? Do they have a clear understanding of their assignment and what's going on? Now, we went through the implementation phase, you know, in veteran OTAs, but now it's time to really put it into action, right? And so I don't want to see a bunch of pointing. You're my fault. Do I got, you know, Dan Quinn blowing his whistle? Stop. Do it again. If you ever played football, football coaches love that. Stop. Do it again. Over and over. Like, I want to see who is grasping the concepts and who is not really getting, because it's really important, especially when you have Tampa Bay coming out the gate, that you understand clearly what is your role and what should you be doing as far as your assignment is concerned. So I want to see that. I'm definitely going to be keeping my eye on that. But I feel like Dan Quinn is a teacher's coach. He's going to be wanting to be hands-on, as we all saw, and making sure that the players really grasp what's going on. The second thing I want to talk about is what rookies will emerge, right? And we spoke about this briefly last night. So my guy Bluff said, you know, typically good teams, which we are a damn good team, to be honest with you, you only have about 4 to 5 rookies max who really make the final roster and actually really having some type of impact. So who would those guys be? Because I know a lot of Cowboys fans during the draft, you know, we had 11 damn picks and we think all 11 of them are going to be starting day one and playing. And like, that's not how it works. It's not college football, right? And so you think about it, we know Micah Parsons is a lock, right? We hope Kelvin Joseph is a lock, which I would say he is, right? I would say Nashawn Wright would be a lock. That's three. So if we're going off of four, we got one more. I would go with Osa Odighizuwa as being my fourth guy if I had to pick, right? So that's four, you know, solid rookies coming out of this year's class that's going to be able to contribute, you know, earlier on. But that kind of leaves a few people out. That leaves out Chauncey Golston, who I kind of like. I know a lot of people really don't like Chauncey Golston, but I like what Chauncey Golston has to bring to this team. You know, he's kind of been up and down as far as consistency is concerned, but I think he has that thing to be disruptive defensively. That also leaves out Jabril Cox, right? A lot of people have spoken highly about Jabril Cox, self-included. That's a linebacker that a lot of us were excited about. Then I also think about Simi Fiocco, Quentin Bohannon, the list goes on, Josh Ball, the list goes on and on and on. But I don't think that we're going to have seven rookies actually be on this final roster, right? So it's going to be interesting to see who shakes out. Israel Mokwamu was another one. So how do things really shake out as far as this rookie core? Who becomes practice squad guys? Who are, you know, are kind of bubble guys? We have to really pay attention to that to see who is going to emerge. So speaking of emerging, my third thing, right? It's going to be that outside corner position, right? I can't say that enough, right? Who is going to be the other outside corner outside of Trayvon Diggs? Is it going to be Anthony Brown? I guess. Is it going to be Kelvin Joseph? Is it going to be Nashawn Wright? Is it going to be Reggie Robinson? Who is really going to step up at camp and just take over that position and be like, this is mine, I'm the guy, you can count on me? And so you're going to be seeing tweets and videos and all sorts of things. I think the cornerback position will definitely be one of those highlighted positions that you're going to hear about frequently, especially in preseason. We're all going to keep our eye on to see who is going to be that guy to be our cornerback two outside of Diggs. Four, I think that's four, right? Of course, linebackers, right? The linebacker room. Me personally, I love linebackers. Was one myself, right? And so finally, we have competition in-house at the linebacker position. We have Micah Parsons, who we know is going to be there. We have Jalen Smith, who we know is going to be there. We have LVE, you know, we got Keanu New. And so we start to kind of see how things are going to work out. So when I'm at camp and when I'm watching things and kind of checking tweets and everything going on, I'm going to see how the rep percentages have actually been breaking down. You know, who is starting at Mike linebacker for the most reps for today's camp? You know, who's going to be at the wheel? Who's been at, you know, at the strong side, the Sam? Like, how is this rotation really working? And who is really getting a bulk of the reps? Earlier on, I think it's going to be Jalen. You'll see a lot of Micah Parsons and a lot of LVE. But is it going to be Cal O'Neill? What's going to happen with Jabril Cox and so on? So I definitely want to keep my eye on the linebacker core. Next thing, let's go to the offensive side of the ball. Offensive line rotation. Now, we know we got the Great Wall 2.0-ish back in Dallas with Tyron being healthy, Lyle being back, Zach Martin being back, Tyler Biotish coming in, you know, in his second year, and then also Connor Williams. Now, my guy Bluff mentioned this last night, and you definitely wanted to keep your eye on this, that if something unfortunate was to happen with Tyler Biotish, knock on wood, no injuries, no whammies. Salute to Cam Akers, get well, bro. But if something was to happen with Tyler Biotish, we have nobody currently in house that has any center experience at that position. And so it's like, it's going to be kind of interesting to see what happens. Do they bring in a veteran such as Joe Looney coming into play? Do they bring in, you know, one of these undrafted free agents, whether it's Braylon Jones from Houston, or do we slide someone to the center position? That's going to be interesting to see, because who's going to be that second center behind Tyler Biotish and how the rotation, the offensive line will be? Because you still have McGovern, you still have Knight, and then you add in Josh Ball, and then you have Terrence Steele from last year. You have, you know, four kind of guys that's kind of that death piece, but how that rotation actually work out remains to be unseen. And then another thing I'm definitely going to keep my eye on, and I mentioned this on Twitter, you know, it was Hot Take Tuesday, I guess we can call it. Which undrafted free agents will actually make the roster? And I said there's going to be three, right? I feel like it's going to be one of the wide receivers who are going to crack through. We spoke about this last night as well. Like, all right, we brought in, you know, TJ Vasher, who's one of my favorites. Now, I'll say this. I don't think that TJ Vasher is going to be that guy. But we also brought in Simi, who was a drafted player, right? But you have Brennan Eagles. You have Brandon Smith. You have Osiris Mitchell at Mississippi State. And so you have some of these guys that kind of fill out the same void as possibly a Noah Brown or a Cedric Wilson. So will one of these guys be able to come in and actually take a spot? I say so. I think there will be one wide receiver undrafted free agent that makes the roster. Secondly, a guy that I kind of have coined is Tyler Coyle, right? The safety, kind of linebacker, hybrid player out of Purdue, though he did play at UConn as well. Now, he's going to be a diamond in the rough player, and with the safeties that we currently have in-house, he's going to have to beat someone out. Like, it's going to be Thompson and McQuarrie. Like, how is he going to make the roster? But I feel like if he can flash and show his versatility, he might be a player that Dallas Cowboys will want to keep on this roster, maybe stash in the special teams for, you know, a year or two until they can, you know, find a role for him. And then, you know, a player that I mentioned earlier was Braylon Jones, offensive guard slash center out of the University of Houston. So will he just be that guy that the Dallas Cowboys will say, you know what, this is kind of our swing guy that we can use at the center position and also guard and kind of let him play behind Tyler Biadasz, or will they bring in a veteran? I know a lot of people last night were talking about Nick Ralston, the guy who's kind of like a tight end, fullback slash line. He's just a football player. Where the Dallas Cowboys keep a traditional fullback remains to be unseen. But when you watch Ralston, he is kind of just a football player, right? And so I feel like he's going to be one of those blue-collar guys that Mike McCarthy's going to look at and is like, all right, I just want you on this roster some way, somehow, right? I'm going to find something for you to do and put you on this roster. So maybe he's a tight end. Maybe he's a fullback. Maybe, you know, who knows? He could be maybe a fourth guy that you want to keep your eye on. Another guy who's one of my favorites personally, but the linebacker room is just too tight. Anthony Hines, the third, out of Texas A&M. He kind of reminds me, if you watch my draft videos, you know, I was very high on Cameron McGrone out of Michigan, who went to the Patriots. He kind of reminds me a little bit of Cameron McGrone. So he has the athleticism. He's inconsistent. He's more of a project. But can he beat out a Luke Gifford or a Francis Bernard? Really remains to be unseen. So that's it, fam. Tell me below in the comments, who are you guys watching for camp and what kind of stories you're watching for camp? Like I said, I'm excited. Cowboys football season is finally here. Like I said, a lot of my content creating friends are going to be out there, so I can't wait to link up with them, man, and talk this Dallas Cowboys football. And tonight, I'm going to be joining my Star Gang family on their podcast show at 8 p.m. Central, so definitely tune into that. Professor O, Mary Ella, Spoonie, and BJ Nix. We can continue to keep this train rolling because we hear Cowboys fans. So it's like, you know what? Let's keep the things going. Let's keep the things going, man. You guys are going to see me all over the place. I am refreshed and ready to work, and I'm ready to grind, man. So let's get to it, man. So it's your boy, Jay Tuck. Hopefully everyone's having a great Wednesday, great hump day. Hopefully everyone stays safe, stay blessed, stay encouraged, and go Cowboys. It's football season, and it's football season too. Go sport.
What's up, CFO gang? It's your boy, Jay Tuck. And if you like that content, make sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on that notification bell to stay updated with all Dallas Cowboys news. Also, go to CowboysFansOnly.com so you can stay dripped in your official CFO gear and use the code CFO gang to get 10% off all your purchases. How about them Cowboys?